Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. The parables of the New Testament are on my fingertips. And here I'm going to explain Matthew 20, verse 2 to 8. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by Jesus, the Anointed Christ of the Most High, Living God, Elohim, within us called Emmanuel. This is the temple of God. God lives in His temple here. If it's clean, if it's no have got greed in it, or what you call blood money in it. If it has blood money, God is out and Satan is in. Remember Judas Iscariot got blood money, those 30 shekel. And that blood money did not allow him to have God within himself. Here I'm doing Matthew 20 verse 2 to 8. On the first day of the week after Passover, Mary Magdalene ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other brethren and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis who were natural men. In this one, we need to be twice-born supernatural brethren. A corruption by the Messianic Jews, especially of the Judah tribe, they have made corruptions in the New Testament, as it was under the church was under their control. They start killing the apostles by throwing them before the animals to be eaten alive. Light came among his own and they created darkness. And they were the last one sheep whom Jesus loved. Lost sheep out of the 100, which Jesus spent almost all his life in the Judea region to redeem the lost sheep. And they killed our shepherd, anointed Christ Jesus. So here it is. Then the Mary Magdalene, you know, she ran and to his brethren and went to Simon Peter, whom Jesus loved, and told them, they have taken our brother and not the Lord, that have slaves from the tomb. The Lord, the word Lord, and all that things have been introduced from the temple. The Yahweh is the Lord, Lord of creation. And in Jesus we have one Father. We don't have Lord. Lords have slaves. Our Father has sons. Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High and not the slaves of the Most High. Sons have the right to enter the house as they like it. Slaves are not allowed. That is why when Jesus was entering the temple and then he asked Peter, does the Father charge you for entering his house? Peter said no, but that was no more the house of our Father. That had been of the Satan. And that is why they were asking money from Jesus to enter his own house. That did not belong to him anymore. It belonged to Satan. And in some churches you see them, especially St. Paul's Cathedral in London, it is such a rich church headed by Queen. Queen is the head of Mammon in Great Britain, and they have so much property. And still, if you want to enter St. Paul's Cathedral, they ask you entrance fee of £5 or £10 just to go around. So that is not the house of our Father, it's house of Satan. And that's why over there the statues of Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, etc., who ruled over people and their soldiers who killed people, they say they glorified God. What type of God was that? But of Mammon. So this Church of England is Church of Mammon, Church of Satan. Whereas Salvation Army people are brethren. And they loved God, they loved their people. And no more to be found there. So you have to be careful. So lords have slaves that they introduce. They have, from the tomb, they have, you know, taken it away. Remember that Jesus was the second Adam. He came floating, born of a virgin, has no tribal father, so no tribal property. And that's why foxes have hole to rest their head, but the Son of Man, Christ Jesus, had no place to rest his head, or no secular property. So he left no mark when he left the world. Because this world belonged to the sons of Adam, who have the tribal property and all that, you know, and they are left mark as graves and other things they make for in their honor. But Jesus had nothing of this world. He came floating and floating he went. And we don't know where they put him. People of the book will gulp what is written, whilst those of the spirit chewing with the logical reasoning, what is written are corruptible scripture. What is written is corruptible, you know. That's why the gospel is received from our Father only. And through revelations. Revelations are, you receive it through logical reasoning. That is why in Punjabi we call it Durki Bani. Durki Bani means that it comes from God. Nobody else can give you. Jesus had 12 laborers. Out of the two, one Peter was once born. He could not get gospel. And the other, Judas Iscariot, he was a thief. He was stealing money. Twice born, but loving Mammon. So to Peter, Jesus showed him, when Jesus asked Peter, what do you think of me? He said, you are the living Christ of living God. Then Jesus stressed to him, unless our Father give you this, his word, this knowledge, you can't have it. He became arrogant, you know, and started rebuking Jesus. And Jesus then rebuked him. And that, Son, if you want to show to someone, and they can see it. What is written are corruptible scriptures and make sense out of it. We make sense out of this scripture, you know, what this gospel has been written by the corrupt Messianic Jews. Thus, gospel is for the twice-born people of Holy Spirit, common sense, and not for the once-born natural men of letters. So Peter and the other brother went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other brother ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in, because Jesus always asked Peter what the people think or what the people say about him, and he will speak the truth. So the matter of speaking what you see with your two naked eye to describe was given to Peter only. So that's why they did not enter the tomb. They wanted Peter to go inside to see what he saw and then tell the people. So Peter was given the authority to speak the truth about what he saw. No one could doubt what Peter said. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place, that my job is not finished yet, and I will come again. This he predicted in his saying, as the lightning strikes or originates in the east and flashes towards the west, in that the people of the east, being greedy, will not be able to appreciate the light. But of the honest and longing people of the west, so shall be the coming, so shall be the second coming of the Son of Man. And that was Satguru or Christ Nanak Dev Ji of India, Punjab, where I come from, who appeared in 1469, and although he preached gospel to perfection through five more lives, altogether six of them, you know, preached gospel for 150 years, yet the darkness could not be comprehended. And our father himself, in the form of royal king, Sache Patshah Gobind Ji, just wondered. Hello? ਹਾਂ 5 ਮਿੰਟ ਨੂੰ ਕਰੀ ਹਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਨਹੀਂ 5 ਮਿੰਟ ਨੂੰ ਰੋਇਲ ਕਿੰਗ ਸੋ ਆਵਰ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੀ ਡਾਰਕਨੈਸ ਕੁਡ ਨਾਟ ਬੀ ਕੰਪਰੀਹੈਂਡਿਡ ਐਂਡ ਆਵਰ ਫਾਦਰ ਹਿਮਸੈਲਫ ਇਨ ਦੀ ਫਾਰਮ ਆਫ ਰੋਇਲ ਕਿੰਗ ਵੀ ਕਾਲ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਰਾਏ ਜੀ ਅਪੀਅਰਡ ਟੂ ਗਿਵ ਦੀ ਫਿਨਿਸ਼ਿੰਗ ਟੱਚਿਸ ਟੂ ਦੀ ਲਾਸਟ ਟੂ ਫਿਲੰਥ੍ਰੋਪਿਕ communities of religion, Khalsas and the soldiers of Akal Purakh, are of God and not of any secular authority. They don't work for money, they work for philanthropic work purely. And the fourth community of apostles who took to wilderness preaching gospel in the villages and towns. The apostles, they are not married. So they devote their whole life to preaching gospel. That's why the five who were initiated by Royal King Gobind Rai, when the Khalsa was established, five were beheaded on stage. Then the head of one and the torso of the other was sewn, and then with the nectar poured into their mouth, nectar is his word, they were made alive. And by seeing this miracle, the people then took, they got baptism of Khalsas, or the baptism of Gobind Rai, Sache Patshah Gobind Rai, and they became Khalsas. So Khalsas are not householders. They can't live in their houses as they do it today. And same as with the, out of those Khalsas, those who are interested in preaching gospel, they became apostles, and then they were sent to the Akal Takht in Amritsar, the seat of them, but the crook Khatris, they threw them out because they loved darkness. So how the Sikhi was corrupted by people of Khatri tribe, they are the kings and emperors of darkness. I'm going to put a video after this one. The preaching gospel in the villages and towns, they never pocketed money or carried any holy books. They did not carry any holy books with them. They learned the Hindu scriptures from Banares, the Jerusalem of India. Banares is the same as Jerusalem of India, University of Hinduism, as Jerusalem is the University of Jewishism. and with the knowledge of his word by grace. They got this knowledge only by grace, if you get it, his word. That means gospel. Gospel is different from scriptures. Scriptures are letters, and gospel is always received through revelations. That is why it cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of heart. Then the other brother also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. So what Peterson first had seen it, he described the scene as it was. So the mouth cloth and other thing was separate, mean that he has not finished his work yet. So Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. This golden temple is of the same size as the holiest of holy used to be in Jerusalem. They tried to rebuild it 3 times, but a fire came in the foundation, won't let them build the temple. Only the western wall is in, western wall is standing, because the west is the direction. When you want to repulse the Satan, you face west and throw 7 stones. Now, you know, to this western wall, they can throw 7 stones, but they are hanging their prayers. So this western wall is for the sons of Satan, the tares. They are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is being fulfilled. So end of the world is coming soon. So better wake up, join hands, and let's preach gospel of our loving Father, Par Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm.